I'll just plug in there. So now what I'll be using is Mock 20 in 1. So it's got everything in it, heaps, hecton, like everything basically in it. And then I'll be ready to put that through the hair. And then it's gonna. And then I'll change the towel because it'll be damp for the client. But for now, we probably don't even need the towel. I'll just brush through the hair. Then. Huh? How do you make some sure?
What do you mean I'm waiting?
I can't, my legs are on. And then once I've brushed through this client's hair, I will get like a penny of the product, so like that much.
Yeah.
And then I'll rake it. You don't need too much, I'll just rake it through her hair, make sure her roots are all covered, everything about the hair.
And what does this do to the hair?
So it's just like oil, so it makes the hair smooth once it's been blow dried, and it's also a heat protectant, which is good. So if anything, it won't damage the hair when there's heat on it.
And you would use this with a client with longer hair, not for
any hair.
Yeah, right.
it's like good for curly hair. Any types of hair, it's good for. So yeah. And then what I'll do now is I'll get my pintail comb. And then I'll do like a hot cross bun technique. So I'll do down the middle, parting down the middle. And then once I've parted down the middle, I'll go across to the back of the ear. And then, so there's like a line. Like here, and then I'll pin this bit up. And then I'll go straight down here to here, and then pull it back like this, and then pin it up. So then they're my sections, and then what I'd do is I'd go from here to the top of the ear on an angle, round the back like this, just so I can section the hair for blow drying. Sections to put first.
So you section the hair to make sure that. Why do you do this?
So we always dry the back first.
Right.
So then if we're going to say this client just wants it flat, we'll do it flat. And then if we're going to do volumizing, we'll do volume. And then we'll make sure that the hair sits flat. So if I was going to blow dry all back, it'd be very puffy and very volumized. But if we're going to blow dry the sides and this bit section, it'll be very flat and straight. Right. So I'm just going to do a smooth blow dry. So it's not too much. And then I'll bring my trolley over. And because she's got thick hair, I'll be using a 89 brush, so it's more bigger and easier for me to dry. And then we'll just section the hair into the brush. And then we keep it on medium, like medium everything, so it's not too hot for the client. And then we just blow dry. Normal, so make sure you pull it down instead of like curling it, so it's easier to blow dry and easily, like easier to control the hair.
want a towel?
No.
To do is make sure that the roots are more dry than the ends, because then you can always work with the ends and you do the rest of the hair. So you always make sure that the roots are dry before you do, well, you do the whole thing eventually, but it's all right if the ends are a little bit more damp than the rest of it. Now what I'm doing is I'm just going over the ends to make sure they're all dry. And then it's like a smooth and silky thing. I don't, the client has frizzy hair, so it won't be as smooth, but it's smooth. And then I'll do the next section. So before I just go around with this.
Emily, do you mind if I'm having a conversation with you?
Just comb through it so it's all nice and detangled. Then I'll get my section, so I'll do my three sections at the back again. So I'll start with the side section, get the brush underneath. Okay. way to the back section. I just bring my fingers through it to make sure everything's dry underneath and then on top of this bit. And then I need to make sure that ends are dry because I think I'm trimming a bit of your hair off. Okay, so I might be trimming, so I make sure that everything's straight and smooth so it's easy for me to cut the hair. So I'll just cut the hair dry instead of wet. It should only happen a little bit off. Just got a bit of a knot. And then I will round this bit, and then we literally just have on the crown bit, what the pin. And then we literally just have this left bit to, on the crown to blow dry after this little bit. That's not your face, is it? Okay. Make sure it's all even. And then because it's all mixed in with the wet and the dry hair, I'll just take a bit of a section from the middle now. And then even though I've dried it, it still will be smoothed over with the wet bit. And then I'll just get my brush, go underneath. So always put the brush by the root and push it up and then down. So it's like that. And then there. And I'll get the other bit. Thank you. because now the hair's getting thicker at the back, I will pull it on the higher speed, but they keep the temperature the same, medium. And then just keep going individually with the sections. Checking the hair to make sure you've got every section dry, and then just to dry these bits of hair so they don't drip on the pollen. And then now I'll do my last section, and I'll just split that into two so it's just easier to do it. Hold on, I'm pulling it. Yeah, try not to pull the hair. Sorry, Ellie.
It's
So with a client with long hair like Ellie's, you're looking at about 20 minutes, really, effectively?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah, like 20 minutes, maybe 25.
Yeah.
Yeah, this depends how fast you are and how, like, good you are keeping the time, and the time limit.
Yeah.
So now this bit is all smoothed and dried. what I'll do is I'll just, the root bit, I'll just go over with my hand and the hairdryer, just to make sure that everything's dried, because I will be straightening it. Yeah. So just make sure that everything's nice and smooth and nice and dry. So now these you can do is how big a section you feel comfortable doing the section, so because Ellie has bangs too, I'll be switching my brush to the smaller one. And when you're using this, try not to keep it on the medium, like strength, like thing, because you don't want to burn the client's ear or anything like that. So you keep it away from her head, but still drying the hair. Away till it ends, and then I'll do them bits last. Obviously, because the client will still keep moving ahead, so you just got to learn to like adapt around how the client moves ahead. So you see what I'm like, trying to, because then he keeps moving ahead. Obviously, because these bits are more baby hairs than actual hair, so it will be a bit more frizzy, and then I'll put straighteners over it. But in order to, with a smooth blow dryer, you want to smooth it enough so you just don't have to put that much heat, like actual hair straightener heat on it. So you just have to go once over it and it'll be fine. So like, I'd only have to do like these bits here that are a bit frilly. And yeah, like the dents and then I'll turn my head again. So I'll just blow dry the rest of this bit. Do you want me to put your bangs on?
Blow dry all together and then we'll put the bangs on.
Thank you. using the hairdryer now.
So this is the same process you carried out with the other side of the hair?
Yeah, so I just do the exact same what I did last time, and then, yeah. And just to make sure that the wire's like not tangled as well. Yeah. Let me go to the